In an era where global threats loom over vast distances and unpredictable terrains, the United States Army is preparing to unveil the next chapter in vertical lift technology, the Future Long-Range Assault Aircraft, or FLRAA. This revolutionary program promises to reshape how American forces and our allies respond to crises, conduct battlefield operations, and project power across oceans. Imagine an aircraft that can take off like a helicopter, transition swiftly into airplane mode, and fly twice as fast and twice as far as traditional rotorcraft. This is the Army's vision for FLAA, a vision spurred by the need to replace the venerable Sikorsky UH-60 Black Hawk, a design that served admirably for over half a century, yet now faces the demands of the 21st century battlefield. Army Futures Command's commanding general, James E. Rainey, underscored the significance of this upgrade, especially as U.S. forces pivot to potential operations in the vast Pacific region. Covering massive distances requires rotorcraft with unprecedented speed, range, and agility, and FLRAA aims to deliver on all fronts. Black Hawk's legacy. Before we dive deeper into FLRAA's cutting-edge design, we must first honor the Black Hawk's place in aviation history. Serving the Army and over 35 governments worldwide, the Black Hawk has shouldered a wide range of missions: air assault, troop transport, medical evacuation, humanitarian relief, and more. The Army will continue to purchase these helicopters even as it readies the FLRAA. Under current plans, 24 Black Hawks will be purchased annually through 2026, and additional multi-year contracts may follow. This dual approach ensures that America's helicopter fleet remains capable, modern, and ready to serve until FLRAA is fully online in the 2030s. The Future Vertical Lift Initiative. FLRAA isn't an isolated project. It's part of the Army's broader Future Vertical Lift, FVL, initiative, launched in 2009 to overhaul Cold War-era aircraft with modern rotorcraft that carry heavier payloads, move faster, travel longer distances, and require less logistical support. Originally, FVL consisted of multiple efforts: FLRAA, the Future Attack Reconnaissance Aircraft, FARA, and New Unmanned Aerial Systems, UAS. But in the Army's fiscal year 2025 budget request, the FARA program was proposed for cancellation. The Army instead focuses on FLRAA's rapid development, alongside next-generation UAS platforms. FLRAA requirements and capabilities. With the Army seeking to double speed and range, FLRAA aims for cruising velocities of up to 280 knots, significantly outpacing the Black Hawk's 151-knot cruise speed. The goal: fly 12 passengers up to 1,700 nautical miles without refueling, operate at 6,000 feet in up to 95-degree heat, and accommodate missions ranging from aerial assault to humanitarian aid. In 2014, two industry teams, Bell and a Sikorsky-Boeing collaboration, received contracts to develop demonstrators. Bell's creation was the V-280 Valor, which soared for the first time in December 2017. Sikorsky-Boeing unveiled the SB-1 Defiant X, a compound helicopter with twin coaxial rotors and a pusher propeller, which took flight in March 2019. Bell V-280 Valor, the Army's choice. After evaluating both demonstrators, the Army awarded Bell Textron a $1.3 billion contract in 2022 to deliver a digital FLRAA prototype of its V-280 Valor by 2025. The Government Accountability Office affirmed the Army's decision, citing Sikorsky's failure to address critical requirements for a modular open system architecture, MOSA. Why tilt-rotor? Tilt-rotors take off and land vertically, like helicopters, but tilt their rotor blades forward for airplane-like efficiency in cruise flight. Bell's V-280 incorporates design lessons from the V-22 Osprey, simplifying the tilt-rotor mechanics with a straight wing and a more straightforward clutch arrangement. Bell's partners: Rolls-Royce provides two AE-107F turboshaft engines, the same power plant used in the V-22 Osprey. Spirit Aero Systems constructs the composite fuselage, Safran supplies the landing gear, Moog develops flight control computers and components, GE Aerospace contributes an open architecture backbone, data recorder, and health awareness systems. Astronics Corporation handles the power and distribution system. Moving toward production, in the Army's fiscal year 2025 budget request, $1.26 billion is allocated for continued FLRAA research, development, testing, and evaluation. These funds fuel FLRAA's engineering, management, and development activities, particularly the digital backbone and MOSA integration. With this approach, the Army ensures that future software and systems upgrades can be done quickly and cost-effectively. In May 2024, FLRAA was named a Pathfinder program for implementing digital engineering and acquisition, signaling the Army's resolve to establish FLRAA as a model for future defense projects. U.S. Special Operations Command has also contributed feedback, requesting design provisions for specialized equipment, like a radar in the nose and a refueling probe. These collaborative efforts underscore the program's broad applications across multiple military branches and mission profiles. Milestone B and the road ahead. On August 2, 2024, the Army announced FLRAA's advancement into Milestone B, the engineering and manufacturing development phase, after a successful preliminary design review in April and thorough assessment by the Army Systems Acquisition Review Council in June. This progression unlocked the first of 9 contract options, which include designing and building 6 prototype aircraft. The inaugural FLRAA prototype flight is slated for 2026, followed by low-rate initial production in 2028, and the first fielded units arriving by 2030. FLRAA funding support. Congress remains watchful over FLRAA's trajectory. The House-passed version of the fiscal year 2025 National Defense Authorization Act, the Senate Armed Services Committee's fiscal year 2025 NDAA proposal, and corresponding defense appropriations bills all recommend fully funding the Army's request for FLRAA RDT and E in fiscal year 2025. Considerations for Congress. As the FLRAA program moves from the drawing board to the battlefield, Congress continues its vital oversight role. Among the questions they grapple with, 1. Autonomy versus manned operations. Army officials envision future aircraft that could fly without human pilots. Others argue pilots remain indispensable, especially in high-stakes combat. Will FLRAA's cockpit remain manned, become fully autonomous, or occupy a middle ground? 2. Air-launched effects. ALEFLRAA may work hand-in-hand with swarms of small unmanned systems, providing surveillance, jamming capabilities, and extended communications networks. Congress may demand updates on how these experimental systems integrate with FLRAA. 3. Maintaining and modernizing the Black Hawk. Even as FLRAA advances, the Army and international partners continue to rely on new UH-60 models. Is it feasible and financially viable to maintain this two-pronged approach? 4. Tilt-rotor safety concerns. Fatal accidents involving the V-22 Osprey have raised alarms about tilt-rotor safety. Congress wants reassurance that lessons learned by the Navy and Marines will inform FLRAA development. 5. Joint service compatibility. Could FLRAA fulfill roles for the Navy's future vertical lift requirements? This synergy might reduce overall costs and streamline training if FLRAA's design is adaptable for maritime operations. The stakes have never been higher. On a modern battlefield, where speed and range can dictate victory or defeat, the future long-range assault aircraft represents the Army's bold leap into a new era. Guided by stringent performance goals, modular open system architecture, and informed by decades of operational lessons, FLRAA promises to be more than just another helicopter. It may well define the future of American vertical lift. As the Army, industry partners, and Congress chart the path forward, the eyes of the world watch in anticipation. This is the story of FLRAA, the aircraft that aims to revolutionize how the United States Army flies into tomorrow's conflicts and humanitarian missions. Its success or failure could reshape the very nature of modern warfare. Thank you for joining us on this deep dive into the future long-range assault aircraft. If you found this information valuable, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to Combat Tech. Stay tuned for more in-depth looks at the cutting-edge innovations shaping modern warfare, and get ready to explore the future of military technology right here on Combat Tech.